All right, everybody, what is up? It's Thunder. Welcome back. And we got some Black Ops 3 today for you guys, man. Had to take a break. Had to put the strobe light adjusters down, man. The battery was starting to go dead. Had to recharge the battery a little bit. So while that recharges, you know what I'm saying, over on Black Ops 4 with that strobe light cheese, man. I was turning try-hards into cry-hards, baby. Oh, my goodness. That strobe light adjustus. Oh, man, I wish I could put a strobe light on the Peacekeeper. Wouldn't that be something? Anyway, man. So yesterday, I was expecting a Call of Duty reveal. I think we all were. I was expecting something like, I don't know, maybe MW4 to get revealed yesterday. Because I know that they flew the COD VIPs, the Call of Duty influencers. By the way, I am not, apparently, not a Call of Duty influencer. So that's cool, right? I mean, I can come out here and say whatever I want. I don't influence anybody. No one's going to take my opinion seriously. I'm not an influencer. I'm just a guy who once had a very popular YouTube channel, and now, thanks to the YouTube algorithm, I can barely hit 20k views on a COD video. Thank you, algorithm. I appreciate that. Matter of fact, my community channel that I'm uploading even less content to is doing way better than my main channel. I mean, look at this from my Social Blade, bro. Look at my main channel. Dude, losing subs daily. Losing subs every day. There's nothing I can do to stop it. It's been like this for 3 months. Like, I can't gain a sub if I paid for it, man. And then you go look at my Thunderstruck Gaming channel. The channel that I upload the same exact content to, actually less content, because I don't even do commentaries there. And that channel's blowing up. Uploading less content, less quality content. No disrespect to any of my community people that upload there. No disrespect, believe me. But it just don't make any sense. It don't make any sense, bro. But whatever. Whatever, see? I thought maybe Call of Duty was dying, which, I mean, let's face it, it is, because they just turned it into a mobile game. But we'll get into that in a second. I thought Call of Duty might be dying. Maybe that's why I'm losing views. But obviously not. Because TSG is blowing up. And there's other guys out here. Deesmo, Korean Savage, and Prince Lightskin Swag. They're all blowing up with subs. So obviously, Call of Duty's not dead. And there are channels that are popping. You got those three channels. My Thunderstruck Gaming channel's blowing up. Just uploading live comms. I'm not even doing commentaries there. I'm doing less content there. And that channel's blowing up. While this channel is just, I don't know, it just seems to be cursed. There's people getting unsubbed to me all the time. And you know what? YouTube, you're not deleting my active inactive subs. You're deleting my active subs as well. I mean, look at this. You know what I'm saying? I get dozens of messages like this daily. Like, yo, why do I keep getting unsubscribed to you? I don't know what's going on, fellas. But I might have to switch full-time from this channel over to TSG. We'll see. I'll keep you posted. But this channel is like the Titanic, bro. This shit is... It hit an iceberg someplace. It's just going down, man. I mean, hey, it wouldn't be the first time I had to start over, bro. You know what I'm saying? Every setback in life is an opportunity for a comeback, man. I'm not even sweating it. I know you guys will be there to watch my loyal subs, no matter what channel I'm on, so I'm cool. Anyway, so fellas, like I was saying, man, yesterday a whole bunch of COD influencers got flown out to playtest some secret Call of Duty. Oh, damn, my VMP blast suppressor guy. How I've missed you. Oh, how I've missed the VMP blast suppressor nerds. Oh, I miss those guys. They go flowing out to playtest some secret COD. I was thinking it was going to be MW4, right? I mean, that's what everybody was thinking. Turns out, they go flown out to play COD Mobile. I was like, what? Y'all got flown out to play a mobile game? Give me a break, bro. Like, who plays Call of Duty on their phone, man? Don't get me wrong. This game does look cool. First of all, it's free to play. Damn, I tore this lobby up. Look at that camo, man. That's called the Garnett camo. Like Kevin Garnett. That's called the Garnett camo, man. You guys can find that in the extras in your when you go to customize your camo. It looks like Black Ops 4 Dark Matter, except it don't grow the horns. But it looks just like Black Ops 4 Dark. So there you go, fellas. I got Black Ops 4 Dark Matter here in Black Ops 3. But this COD Mobile game looks pretty cool. And I'm also almost certain that there's going to be some tech out there that will allow you to cast this game from your phone to your monitor, and you can even probably hook up keyboard and mouse and hook up controllers. Oh man, it's going to be ridiculous. The amount of ways you could cheese this mobile game is going to be ridiculous, man. So what COD Mobile is, it's just like that COD Online game from China. It's going to be all of your favorite COD games, you know, mixed into one, like an everything pizza. You know, you want pizza with everything on it? That's what this COD Mobile game is going to be like. If you're a Call of Duty fan, I mean, imagine being able to call in like a Harrier on a COD World at War map or a Pavlo. Imagine being on Castle calling in a Pavlo or a Harrier. Bro, that sounds fun as hell, man. I mean, that sounds great. I mean, imagine being able to have all your favorite weapons from Modern Warfare 2 running and gunning on a World at War map. That is just, I mean, the ACR on airfield, bro. It just the thought of it is cool, especially if you're an OG COD player that misses the way Call of Duty used to be before everybody started wearing clown wigs in the lobby and dancing and shit and hopping around like bunny rabbits. And there's legit bunny rabbit skins in this game. Like, why would you want to dress up as a bunny rabbit, bro? Literally, a rabbit is prey to everything, every mammal on Earth. Even smaller mammals eat rabbits. Why would you want to dress up as prey? They should have put a wolf skin in this game, son. Let me dress up as a wolf. And damn, it's good to see them red spicy Dorito chips again, the VSAT. But everybody was on the other side of the map this game, bro. Nobody wanted to come anywhere near me. Look at this. I mean, damn, it's good to see you again, VSAT. Just wish I could have done something with you. It's been a while, fellas. I'm a little rusty with my VSAT skills, man. Just all these dudes are running. It's almost like they know I'm here. Like, whoop, that dude got a VSAT. Let's run to the other side of the map. But this COD Mobile game, not only does it look pretty cool, it's free to play, bro. Free to play, which is going to be huge because you will finally attract a lot of players. There's going to be a lot of people playing. There's going to be no more getting in the lobby with the same people 24/7. Now, the mobile phone connections, I didn't even know how that's going to go down. A mobile phone connection? What if you're in the backseat of your car playing while your dad or your friend or whoever drives through a tunnel? Then you go from like 100 ping down to like 1,000 ping. I don't even know if 1,000 ping, if it even go that high, but or that low, however you want to look at it. Damn, I missed these raps, son. Oh my god, the raps. Yo, Black Ops 3 is such a good game, dude. The Black Ops 3 was such a good game. This was probably the most underrated COD game ever made. Black Ops 3 did not get the respect it deserved. A lot of people that hate Black Ops 4 went back and played Black Ops 3 now, and they absolutely love and cherish this game. And I've been saying it all along. I played Black Ops 3 for, what, 3 years? I told you guys, it's a super underrated COD game. And it's just so much better than Black Ops 4. But so COD Mobile is going to be free. And every Call of Duty should be free, to be honest. But because, what does that say? You build Auschwitz in my Minecraft server. What the hell? Yo, who would do that in a Minecraft server? Anyway, man. Listen, guys, I'm going to put the link to all this stuff down in the description. You could go check it out. Because the gameplay here, I'm just so happy to be back on Black Ops 3. I probably didn't talk about everything I want to talk about, but you can read about it down in the description. All the stuff about COD Mobile. It's going to be free to play, which is going to be epic. And there's even going to be COD points in this game. They're going to have a COD point system and a paid tier system. I mean, I wish Black Ops 4 had that. Why does a free mobile game have more content and a better rank up system than Black Ops 4 did? Like, it's embarrassing. It's humiliating, bro. I mean, all right, so here we go right here. I'll put this up on the screen. You can see here, there is a free tier progression. And then there's a premium tier. So you can earn COD points and unlock all the stuff in the top tier. Or you can pay for the premium tier down below. Now, because this game is free, is there going to be pay to win weapons? I don't know. Let me ask Kodak. Yo, Kodak. You think COD Mobile is going to have pay to win weapons?
I hope so.
Okay. Kodak is a millionaire, man. Of course he wants pay to win. Of course he wants pay to win, son. I guarantee there's going to be pay to win. There's going to be really good weapons you could probably buy in that premium tier. COD Mobile going to be the most pay to win COD game ever, homie. Hey, they're giving you the game for free, right? I mean, Fortnite gives you the game for free, but I don't think they have any weapons. In their supply stream, it's just like dance moves, skins, umbrellas that you could fly down to the map in. I don't think Fortnite, it's been a while since I played Fortnite, but I don't think Fortnite's going to pay to win. I mean, there's certainly some OP cheese where if you can find it first, you'll be good, but I don't think they actually have pay to win weapons you can get into the map with. And damn, I missed this Peacekeeper, bro. Oh my god. Yo, fellas, what do you think? Should we just quit playing Black Ops? Should I just retire the Strobe Light of Justice and just come back to Black Ops 3 until MW4 drops? If MW4 even does drop. I mean, this COD Online game could be the COD game we're getting in 2019. I mean, we all saw Robert Bowling chilling with Ghost. That picture, he's pointing at Ghost. That could just mean MW2 Remaster is going to be coming out this year. That doesn't mean MW4 is coming out. I mean, he could just be trolling with the MW4 shit. What if COD Mobile is COD 2019, man? Because they said they thought Black Ops 4 was going to be so good it could last for like three years. Remember that? And this COD Mobile game will have zombies. It will have Battle Royale. And it's just going to be a big mix of all your favorite COD games all in one. It sounds fantastic, man. I wish it was on console, but like I said, guarantee there's tech out there that will allow you to cast that from your mobile phone to your monitor. That emulator cheese, baby. We all know what's out there. We're gonna be seeing it. There's gonna be some crazy gameplays on COD Mobile. I can tell you that right now, because Ping definitely gonna be king on that game. Like I said, man, you want off the nuke and dad drives through the bus tunnel? Uh-oh, bye-bye. There's people going, yo, there's going to be so many people raging on this COD Mobile game. Now, listen, by the way, this is a class setup I use for this video, fellas. You can check it out if you want, but listen, man. We all know that there's rage in Call of Duty. Everyone's going to be raging on this game, too. Now, listen, when I rage in Call of Duty and I slam my scuff controller on the ground and it breaks, I just call up scuff. They send me a new one. I got my $800 mobile phone here. I get mad playing that game. I slam that thing on the ground. I can't call up Apple and be like, yo, Apple, it's Thunder, man. Send me a new phone. They're going to be like, who? So I got to be careful. I don't know if I should even play COD on my mobile phone, man. That could be pretty damn expensive. I think I'm going to get down with that emulator cheese. I do not want to COD in my mobile phone. It just sounds like a dangerous combo, man. I mean, it will be cool to play COD while I'm on the toilet or sitting in line at the bank or I don't know. Being able to play COD anywhere you go kind of sounds scary, dude. Like, when I leave my house, I'm like, cool, Call of Duty's there. I'm out in the world. I'm free. Now Call of Duty can come everywhere we go. Is this good or bad for humanity? Let me know down in the comment section. Thank you guys all so much for watching this Black Ops 3 gameplay commentary. If you want to see more Black Ops 3, let me feel you, babies. Titty smack that like button. Let me know down in the comment section. I appreciate all the support, fellas. Thank you all so much. I'll see you guys on the next one. I'm out. Peace.